This week's episode is sponsored by Patreon supporter Maple Samurai, who's requested a look at the history of the PREDACONS. That's a name that's been used to refer to several groups of animal-themed Transformers from throughout the franchise's history, and in this hefty episode I'm going to run through all of them. But we'll start, as always, with the originals, the Generation 1 PREDACONS. The robots who would become the PREDACONS were originally conceived as a team of heroic Autobots named the Anibots, consisting of Simba the Lion, Shriek the Eagle, Clump the Rhino, Pardo the Leopard, and Thump the Buffalo, who combined into a giant dragon beast. They were initially planned to debut in The Transformers the Movie, helping the Dinobots battle Devastator. But as the idea evolved, the characters were pulled from the film and reinvented as Decepticons, with a more traditional humanoid combined mode, becoming the PREDACONS we know today. Released as part of the 1986 product line, the PREDACONS consist of Razorclaw the Lion, the team's patient leader, the independent, high-spirited eagle, Dive Bomb, Headstrong, the arrogantly self-confident rhino who more than lives up to his name, dangerously unhinged tiger Rampage, and Tantrum, a buffalo with extreme anger issues. Together, they combine to form Predaking, a hair-trigger fighting machine who's the perfect fusion of the Predacon's savage animal instincts. The team lacked the interchangeability of the other combiners released the same year, but made up for it by being much larger. With no counterpart combiner team on the Autobot side, commercials for the Predacon toys positioned them as the opposite numbers of both the Dinobots and Skylynx. The Generation 1 animated series chose to focus on the latter. With their introduction in the movie having been scrapped, the Predacons instead debuted in the cartoon's third season, sent by the Decepticons' alien allies the Quintessons to prevent the delivery of a vital component to Autobot City on Earth. The team were foiled by Skylynx in the first of several face-offs the characters would have during the season. The cartoon didn't provide an explicit origin for the Predacons, but Japanese media would confirm that they had been created for the Decepticons by the Quintessons. In keeping with this, the Sharkticon Gnaw, another unrelated Quintesson creation, was actually sold as a Predacon in Japan. After the end of the cartoon, the Predacons continued to appear in the Japanese exclusive sequel series The Headmasters, in which they gained a new rival in the Autobot-Trainbot combiner Raiden, and they would later return in 1990's Transformers Zone, which featured an infamous scene of Predaking being gruesomely bisected by Autobot-powered master Dai Atlas. Over in the Marvel comic book, meanwhile, the Predacons were a team of elite hunters who were employed by Shockwave to stalk and kill Megatron so he could take over as Decepticon leader. The UK version of the comic would pit them against the Dinobots when an old rivalry between Dive Bomb and the Dinobot Swoop led the two teams into conflict. But as with so many other characters, the Predacons were eventually phased out of the comic following the discontinuation of their toys in 1988, just some of the many victims taken offline by a cosmically powered Starscream. Following the end of the original Transformers toy line, Hasbro kept their trademark on the word Predacon active by using it as the name of an alien in the G.I. Joe Star Brigade toy line in 1994. Which ensured they still owned it a few years later when the time came to introduce the second type of Predacon to the Transformers franchise in 1996's Beast Wars toy line. Used now as the name of an entire faction complete with its own insignia rather than just a five-man team, the evil Beast Wars Predacons and their enemies, the heroic Maximals, transformed into organic-looking animals. The Predacons mostly took the forms of insects, arachnids, and reptiles, and in the Beast Wars cartoon, transformed to robot mode with an iconic cry of
"Terrorize!"
The cartoon explained that the Predacons were the descendants of the Decepticon faction from hundreds of years in the future. They came into being following the end of the war, when a technological quantum leap saw the Transformer race evolve from Autobots and Decepticons into Maximals and Predacons, downsizing into smaller, more fuel-efficient bodies which possessed the ability to reconfigure into organic alternate modes as well as mechanical ones. The Autobots' victory in the war ensured that their descendants, the Maximals, ruled Cybertron, while the Predacons were second-class citizens. And though the two races outwardly coexisted peacefully, many Predacons resented this. The Predacon governing body, the Tri-Predacus Council, played by the Maximals' rules, slowly, secretly amassing resources and power until they felt the time was right to rise up against them. But a renegade named Megatron didn't see things the Council's way. He and his followers traveled to prehistoric Earth with a plan to alter history itself to bring about Predacon dominion over Cybertron, only to be pursued by Optimus Primal's Maximals and eventually defeated in the conflict they called the Beast Wars. Other groups of Predacons appeared in the Japanese spin-off series Beast Wars 2nd, Beast Wars Neo, and Car Robots, later known in English as Robots in Disguise, all also pursuing their own objectives. In the 21st century, ancillary media, mostly from the official Transformers convention BotCon, has linked the Beast Wars Predacons to their Generation 1 namesakes, with stories that have presented the Generation 1 Predacons as either the original founders of, or the inspiration for, the Beast Wars Predacon faction. This, in turn, inspired the release of a new convention-exclusive figure of Razorclaw in 2009, reimagined as a techno-organic beast-era Predacon. An unusual instance of the name Predacon could be found in the Transformers Armada line in 2003, when it was used as the name of an individual Decepticon, a fanatical scientist experimenting in combining organics and technology. Years later, the Transformers Collectors Club's Beast Wars Uprising series of stories would reimagine this character as Predatron, an honorable member of the Beast Wars Predacons who wrote the manifesto on which the faction was founded. 2007's Transformers Animated came close to featuring its own take on the Beast Wars Predacons. Had the show been renewed for a fourth season, they would have appeared as a splinter faction of techno-organic Transformers created and led by Black Arachnia. But it wasn't, and the term Predacon was only ever used in the title of the episode that laid the seeds for Black Arachnia's unfulfilled plans, Predacons Rising. The third major kind of Predacon was introduced in Transformers Prime in 2013. These Predacons were essentially the Cybertronian equivalent of dinosaurs, a species of huge reptilian beasts from Cybertron's prehistory that were wiped out by a cataclysmic extinction event. The Prime animated series detailed how Decepticon scientist Shockwave developed a process to clone the creatures back to life from fossilized remains. But the clones he created were lost when they were sent on an Energon gathering mission to prehistoric Earth, where they would inspire many of the planet's myths and legends about dragons and other fantastical beasts. In the present day, the Decepticons set out to recover the remains of these clones from Earth so that Shockwave could repeat the process and engineer a new army. But when the first of the new clones developed intelligence and the ability to transform and dubbed itself the Predaking, Megatron immediately pulled the plug on the whole project, concerned that the prideful Predaking might turn his new subjects against the Decepticons. This proved to be a self-fulfilling prophecy when Predaking, enraged by the abortion of his clone brethren, did indeed turn on Megatron, then helped the Autobots stop a horde of zombie Predacons reanimated by Unicron from destroying Cybertron. Besides Predaking, the only Predacon clones successfully brought to term in the cartoon were Darksteel and Skylynx, but numerous additional Predacons were released as part of the toy line, and others were featured in tie-in comics. The Japanese spin-off toy line and animated series Transformers Go also introduced its own Predacons, designed to look like Oni, Japanese demons, who battled the Autobot Swordbots over the power of the mystical Legend Discs. Now, outwardly, it's fair to say that beyond their animalistic theme, the Prime Predacons have little to do with the others that have shared the name. but some connections do exist. As with Armada Predacon, the aforementioned Beast Wars Uprising repurposed several prime Predacon characters into members of the Beast Wars Predacon faction. And a story from the United Kingdom's Transformers Prime comic featured a prime Predacon character based on the Generation 1 Predacon, Tantrum. And what about the Generation 1 Predacons? What's happened with them during the 3 decades that all these other characters have been using their name? Well, though they've always remained fan favourites, there's not a lot to tell. They've had a few pieces of merchandise, but in all that time, the only member of the team who got a new transforming toy at retail was Razorclaw. The team didn't feature in any new cartoons, and they made only scattered appearances in comic books. Dreamwave Productions depicted them as a group of warlords who were banished from Cybertron in ages past, who were later found and reprogrammed by Megatron to serve him, and given the ability to combine in the process. In IDW Publishing's comics, the team were Megatron's most elite tactical assault unit, who were stranded on Earth after the end of the war and wound up striking a deal with the government of China to defend the country's borders in return for Energon. Later, they were brainwashed into the service of the European dictator Iron Claw, who gave them the power to combine into Predaking. It wasn't until 2018 that the original Predacons would take center stage again with the release of a brand new set of figures in the Power of the Primes toy line. Sold together in a huge boxed set and clocking in at a towering 18 inches in their combined form, the new toys earned Predaking an appearance in Machinima's Power of the Primes tie-in cartoon, voiced by wrestler Samoa Joe, in which he battled first the Dinobot combiner Volcanicus, then the fallen Prime Megatronus for possession of the mystical Enigma of Combination, only to meet a swift end at Megatronus's hands. Hasbro spent much of the 2010s reconsolidating widely used Transformers names to give them unique, singular meanings again, but that doesn't seem possible with the Predacons. The Generation 1 characters might have been the first, but the use of the name in Beast Wars and Prime was so sustained and prominent, and so tied to the identities and stories of those series, that Predacon has been left a word with multiple equally important meanings that it's hard to see being ignored going forward. You might say, it's one beast that won't be put back in its cage. And those are the basics on the Predacons. Thanks to Maple Samurai for sponsoring this whopper of an episode. Tell me about your favorite version of the Predacons or your favorite team member in the comments. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more from the world of the Transformers.